Hello and welcome back to the Rental Academy. In our previous video, we walked you through how to set up your store's main settings, so now it's time to create your very first product. Let's get started. So, to access products, go to the main side menu and select products. Here you'll see the list of all of your products, which you'll be able to filter and select what product info you want to see in the catalog, like product categories, sales channels, sale price, and so on. Then we'll go to new product. This is pretty self-explanatory, but here you'll be able to add the product name and categories which it will be displayed in. For example, I'm going to add an e-bike to my store in the cycling category. I will also be able to define the base price, and I can select whether it will be a fixed price, so no duration specified for the rental. I can use hourly rentals, days within opening hours, days within 24-hour formats, or weekly rentals. You can also change durations later on when we go through the pricing template. Don't forget to add the tax percentage that you would like to use for this product. You also have the option to use product packages, which allow you to create bundles of products which are meant to be rented out together. So for example, instead of having its own inventory, its availability will be calculated based on the products the package contains. Now add in the basic information. Here you can write a detailed description of your product. In this case, I'll just put that this is X model, suitable for all levels and terrains. You can put, for example, the bike specifications here. And it's good to mention that the description also supports hyperlinks. So later on, when we see this product in the online store, if I put rental.io here, you will be able to click this link. Also on the right hand side, we have the status of the product. Right now it's hidden. So once we've created this product, it still won't be visible to our customers in the online store. So if you wish to make it visible, then you can change this to public and save the changes. You can also add images. You can add one image, or you can also add multiple images, and you can choose which order to use these images. Hit the OK button and then save the changes. The better idea your customers get of the product they want to rent, the faster they make a purchase decision. So definitely take time with product descriptions and images. We have a couple of great guides on how to write product descriptions that sell and the basics of product images. Check out the link in bio. Now onto pricing. In the pricing, you can select whether this will be a fixed price or you can create a pricing table. In this case, we have a base price of 10 euros and we have 1 hour, 2 hours, 4 hours and 1 day as available durations of rental. But of course, you can add many more durations and different types of durations. So if you wish to have more hours, you can select the amount of hours that you would like to add. For example, let's add 5 hours and then we can customize the price here. Let's make it 65 euros for 5 hours. We can also add more days. In this case, we have 1 day within opening hours, so this bike will be returned at the end of the operational day. But of course, if you operate in 24-hour format, then you can add here multiple days in 24-hour formats and change the pricing here as well. If this is the pricing that you're thinking of using for all of your products, then what you can do is you can go to the options on top of the table and you can save this as a new template. Here you can write the template name. So let's put pricing for cycling products and we will create that template. So every time I now add a cycling product, I will be able to use this template that I've already saved. There's also an option to add a booking extension, which is part of one of our paid plans. Basically, it means that your customers would be able to extend the booking during their active booking. We also have variants available, so if you have different sizes or models that you would like the customer to choose from in the online store, you can create this as well, but these would be part of any of our paid plans as well. We do have availability settings. However, we will be diving into this a little bit later. We will create an in-depth video about the inventory. For now, we're going to move on to the settings. These are more advanced settings where you can choose things like additional products. So if you have upselling products that you would like to add, recommending products when renting this product, you can add those here. You can select which sales channels these will be visible in. which stores that they would be visible in. If you had multiple stores, then you can select whether they would be available in one or more than one stores. You can select the customer segments which these would be visible in. You can change the deposit amount for this product. Of course, you would have to first set up your rental payments. You can add additional required product information. These are fields that the staff would have to fill in before the rental starts. You can ask the customer for some additional information, for example, the height, the weight, the shoe size, things like that, just to be able to prepare the orders a little bit better. And then we have some advanced settings. So here we can check the latest that reservations can be made. For example, here I can make it one day before by 6 p.m. So for example, if it's 7 p.m. right now, I would not be able to book this bike for tomorrow. It would have to be for the following day. We can define the online availability as well. We can also select start time. So you can either decide whether to use a start time interval of a certain amount of hours or minutes. If my opening hours here were from 9 till 9 p.m., the start time slots with a 1 hour interval would be at 9, 10, 11, and so on. But I can also use fixed start times. So I can say that on all days, the start times will be at 10 a.m., for example. Here I'm getting a warning that this time is outside my store opening hours. So if you do have start times that are outside of your opening hours, below you can ignore the store opening hours if you wish to allow that start time to be available. And then finally, you can limit the orders per start time, and you can add a maintenance time if you have the block enabled from one of our paid plans. Now that you have created your first product, let's take a look at what your online store looks like. Click online store in the top right corner of your screen, and it will then take you to your online store. As you can see, this is the bike that we just created. If we click on the bike, then we can navigate through the multiple images. We can click on the hyperlink, and then of course we can proceed with the booking flow. As you can see, this store is quite simple. I will show you an example of one of my stores, so you can see the possibilities within rental using some of the features that are already included, or the branding block, for example. So there you go, you've created your first product. In the next video, we'll show you how to create an online booking and how to fulfill your orders. See you next time.